First, our top story. President Biden and Vice President Harris are on their American Rescue Plan promotion tour, playing what we hope is a one-hit wonder entitled, Come on, Eileen, you got $1,400, now f*** off forever. This is definitely a win for millions of struggling Americans, but the jury is still out on whether it'll help anyone actually important.
Congressman, can you really call this bill a success if it had support from the majority of voters, but not Susan Collins?
It is a really big improvement. 73% of the American people supporting this rescue package. That means that Democrats, Republicans, blue state, red state, they're all supporting it. And it's targeted towards the 20 neediest percentile of individuals in this country. It's a big deal, and it's going to help a lot of American people.
Now, come on, Congressman. Joe Biden was taking advantage of a bad situation. Naturally, Americans are going to vote to make their lives better. It's exploitation, and it's disgusting.
You know, this seems like an awful lot of money. There's only got to be, like, what, 500-600 poor people in the country?
If poor people can understand the concept of money, then surely they can understand a job application.
Now, moving on, Governor Andrew Cuomo is emboldened after a new poll found that only 35% of New Yorkers think he should resign immediately, though the poll is skewed considering, statistically speaking, he's groped most of the respondents.
I wonder how many people in nursing homes they asked.
Oh, you know, also this week, in a move that we can only assume is completely unrelated, Cuomo announced this.
Passing marijuana reform and legalizing recreational marijuana. We've tried to do that for the past 3 years. We have to get it done this year.
You know, it is always a good sign that governors only enact humane laws to make up for horrific personal failings.
If he faces allegations of vehicular homicide, New Yorkers might get universal preschool.
Congressman, should the state of New York impeach Cuomo or see how many popular policies they can guilt him into?
I think that Cuomo has to be investigated and held accountable for his actions. But if there's anything that we can do, we can chew gum and walk at the same time. They should be able to pass medical marijuana, recreational use marijuana, and other progressive policy agenda items.
If we take out all of the leaders who are accused of assault, then you won't have a demonic ruling class. And who will be left? A handful of women and Dick Durbin?
I mean, do we want to be governed by some sort of psycho who uses their power for non-sexual pleasure? It's depraved.
That's disgusting.
No,
is that even real?
Thank you.
Moving on, the Biden administration is trying to convince the same people that tried to behead government officials to trust the government to inject something in their arm. And it's not going well. Here's what Biden had to say.
I discussed it with my team, and they say the thing that has more impact than anything Trump would say to the MAGA folks is what the local doctor, what the local preachers, what the local people in the community say.
MAGA folks are famously much more into community building and local government than sensational headlines from a shadowy white figure on a golf course.
Among those refusing to take the vaccine is Republican Congresswoman and lazy historical metaphor Marjorie Taylor Greene.
Now, Congressman, you're pushing a resolution that would expel her from Congress for violent rhetoric. Aren't you being a little hard on the aunt at the Thanksgiving table who's a little wacky and also trying to get everyone killed?
My aunt at the Thanksgiving table didn't incite a mob in order to stop the election, storm the Capitol, and then also use rhetoric to incite political violence.
What a brag!
Here to discuss why he has chosen not to take the vaccine is co-host of the right-wing talk show Hot Take, Tyler Templeton.
Hello, Rich People Show! I'm not taking the Biden COVID-19 vaccine. I only take drugs that went through a rigorous screening process or were vouched for by Flippy, the jacked cashier at GNC.
And what does that rigorous screening process look like, Tyler?
Pretty much watching TV. And the TV says this.
We have incredible drugs. I took something, Regeneron. It was, you know, highly sophisticated stuff.
If hydroxychloroquine has side effects, none of which are death, by the way, then those side effects I may want to endure.
If you've seen this test, where is it?
About 100 of my friends and family, this thing works. It's the miracle
of
all time.
I get a lot of tremendously positive news on the hydroxy. What do you have to lose?
And I have everything to lose if I take the vaccine. My arm will hurt, and I'll have a hard time opening the bottle of my Peruvian unregulated Max T horse semen. Thanks for the hookup, Flippy. Did his head just get smaller?
Now, Tyler, is there any chance you're refusing to take this as an act of defiance against a political system that appears to be slipping from your fingers?
No! Shut up, Dad! I mean, why are you making me play baseball? I mean, I want to dance! I mean, no, these are my core political beliefs.
Okay, I think I see what's going on here. Congressman, could you tell Tyler that you're proud of him no matter what after-school activity he does, and he should take the vaccine?
Tyler, Trump and his wife, Melania, took the vaccination before they left the White House. So you should be like Trump and take the vaccine.
All right. Don't tell any Republicans otherwise. They won't think that I have Nance as big as cats that got into the pizza again. I love you, Congressman.
I love you too, Tyler. Just get your vaccination.
Aww.
Nope.